I'm Vanessa Sorensen, and this is your place for a holistic approach to autoimmunity, helping you get back in control of your health. For this week's video, it's a little bit more personal. I'm joined here with my daughter, Anna, and we're going to talk about our experience going to a conference last week, the National Alopecia Areata Foundation Conference. So as you probably know, I have MS. What you may not know is that my daughter, Anna, has alopecia areata. And Anna, can you tell everyone a little bit about alopecia and what alopecia areata is?
It's when your body is allergic to your hair, making your hair fall out.
Yeah. And are there different kinds of alopecia?
Yes.
Do you want to tell them what they are? Do you
remember? There's alopecia areata, making just patchy. There's alopecia totalis, making all the hair on your head fall out. And there's alopecia universalis, making all the hair on your body fall out.
That's really good. I wasn't even sure if she remembered all of them, so that's great. So last year, Anna lost most of the hair on her head. As you can see, it's growing, it's all growing in. She has a couple of new patches at the back, but overall it's going really well. But the year was really challenging, and for all of us, right? A little bit. You like to wear a hat a lot, would you say, when you...
Yeah, in kindergarten.
In kindergarten, you like to wear a hat, and in grade one. I don't know if you remember, but in grade one.
Not that much.
Okay.
But a little.
Okay. So one thing that I realized is how important it is to have support with things like this, and part of it was because we didn't know anyone else who had alopecia, right?
Yeah.
Like we knew one little boy who had a patch at one point, but he I don't even think that he really
doesn't remember.
Yeah, he doesn't remember.
I asked him.
Okay. So I really wanted to find a way for Anna to meet more kids with alopecia, and I really wanted to get support from other parents and to hear from them. And so I found the National Alopecia Areata Foundation, found out they have a conference every year, and this year we decided to go. And I can tell you, it was amazing. Was it amazing? It was amazing. So we're going to share with you a few of the things that we liked most about it. Anna, do you want to go first or do you want me to go first?
You can go first.
Me? You? Me? Okay. I'm going to go first. So one of the best things is exactly what I was hoping to do there, which was meet other parents and get their perspectives and hear about their experience with their kids, and in particular with school and how to navigate school and talk to people, talk to other parents, talk to teachers, and even talk to other students. So that was really invaluable. And I have met people there who I expect we're going to be keeping in touch with, maybe even see each other next year at the conference. It was fantastic. So that's one thing for sure. Another thing that I wasn't expecting was that I went to a panel by young adults. It was young adults' perspectives. And it was really, really helpful to hear from these young adults in their early 20s and hear about what it was like for them growing up with alopecia areata or totalis or universalis, and hearing what worked for them as kids and what didn't work so well, and really learning from them and hearing loud and clear that it's important for me to honor Anna's, her not only her needs but her feelings and her desires and her how she wants to approach the situation, that I really need to work with her on that and honor her. So I'm so grateful to hear that perspective from them. And then the last thing that I want to mention is that Anna and I both had the opportunity to meet some really incredible young women and older women who are so strong and confident and talented and proud and in various stages of baldness. And it was amazing. And I realized how important it is for Anna to have positive, strong female role models who also have this condition as she grows up. Because right now, you know, Anna has almost a full head of hair, but we don't know, right, Anna? Like, we don't know what's going to happen It's possible that she keeps all of her hair. It's possible that some of it falls out again. It's possible that all of it falls out again. So it's good for us to be prepared for anything, right? Okay, Anna, what about you? What are some of the things that you loved about the conference?
I met great people like Caroline and Isabella. And I got great souvenirs.
Do you want to show the souvenirs? Okay, I'll get them. So here's one. Oh.
This is a lanyard. It says my name and where I live. And these are all the ribbons. They're for free. And can I tell them what they say?
Sure.
Even though they can read them?
Yeah, sure.
They say...
Here, why don't I hold it for you?
VIP.
So we got the VIP because it was our first year at the conference.
Glass half full.
And then the rest, Anna got to pick herself.
I can point. Okay. Know it all. Show me the money. I am not my hair. Diva. Runs with scissors, yada, 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 huh? And plays with others.
And so do you want to show your second souvenir?
Okay.
Okay, we're going to do a big reveal for the second souvenir, so we'll be right back.
Ta-da!
So Anna also got this wig. It's just for fun. We like it, right? But
it was free.
It's true. It was free.
And I got you a new hat.
And yes, and she got a new hat on the free table too. So is there anything else you want to mention?
I got to meet a girl named Molly. I think she is Universalis or Totalis. And she plays bluegrass.
Yeah.
And she's the first really woman to get a medal for some... No,
It's the best guitar player award for the International Bluegrass Awards, I think. Something like that.
And she's really good. She plays a song that's called Good Enough, and I just love it.
So there you go. Is there anything else you want to mention, Anna?
Swimming.
Swimming, yeah, we had a lot of fun swimming. It was in Arizona, so it was super hot, especially like we're from the Pacific Northwest. We're not used to it, but it was great. And so, Anna, would you recommend if someone out there, if one of our viewers has alopecia or is a parent of someone with alopecia, do you think they should go to the conference?
Yes!
Okay, I think that gives you the answer, and I completely agree. I would recommend it to anybody who has alopecia or is a parent of someone with alopecia.
Yes.
It's a really good idea to go. It's an amazing support network, and you won't regret it. So that's our video for this week. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions for me or for Anna, please feel free to just drop them in the comments below. I'll also put a link to the National Alopecia Areata Foundation website, so you can check them out.
It's 10%.
10%? Do you mean 10 out of 10?
Out of 10.
Oh, 10 out of 10.
Or 100 out of 100.
Or, there you go. So, thank you so much for watching again. I hope you're having a lovely day, and we will see you next time. Bye for now.